What's happening? My name is Keith Lorren, and I invented cooking. Today I'm so excited because I'm going to teach you how to make a Southern classic, turkey wings and dressing. Are you ready? So, you know, Maria, all over the United States, people have their versions of stuffings. But in the South, we eat dressing. We don't bother with that stuffing foolishness. And I'm going to show you how to make a real dressing. Look at all the wonderful ingredients that we have here.
Looks great.
Now, I made this home, this cornbread from scratch. This is old-fashioned, country-style buttermilk cornbread that I baked and crushed. So for this dressing, we're going to use two kinds of bread. I have a whole wheat bread that I've toasted and dried, okay. And I have the cornbread. But before we get to this, I'm going to show you what we're going to do. We're going to make what we call a seasoned paste. But first, I got to put on my eye protectors. So in our bowl, I'm going to add bell peppers. I'm going to add celery. I'm going to add freshly chopped onions. And I'm going to add a little bit of green scallions. And this is the seasoning paste we're going to add to our dressing. And it's really simple, but also flavorful. It all together, make sure everything's equally incorporated, and look how fragrant that is. You can smell everything that's in it, can't you?
Wow, I can smell everything.
So first, we're gonna take our seasoning paste along with our Jimmy Dean sage sausage, and I need to be giving me a royalty check for this. We're gonna saute it all together. Ready?
Okay.
Now Maria, I'm teaching you a lot of my secrets. I don't wanna see all my secrets all over the internet now.
I can't promise anything.
Okay, well, in this cup, I know you're looking at me like I'm crazy or whatever, but in this cup, we have an age-old tradition in the South to save our bacon drippings, to save the drippings that come off of the roasted turkey or the roasted chicken, and that's what I have in this cup. So this is what I call my seasoning oil. I don't want you getting all in my seasoning oil like that, but I'm just going to put a few tablespoons like that on there so it's nice and smoky. This is an age-old tradition in the South. Don't tell anybody our secrets.
No, I won't. By the way, I got to try your barbecue rub last week.
It feels so good. You're lying here next to me.
Kept asking me what it was, and I had to tell them. Right. Those on the seasoning was so good.
Thank you so much, sweetheart. I really appreciate that.
Oh, don't thank me. I thank you for your amazing seasoning. I love them all.
But I have to tell you, that barbecue rub that I sell, that I make, it's incredible.
It is.
It's the real deal of barbecue.
That is.
It's the kind of barbecue you get when you go to the hood, and you see those people on the side of the road barbecuing on those smoke drums. That's the kind of barbecue I make.
Everyone was in love with it. Great job.
Okay, so I have this Jimmy Dean sage sausage here. And now I'm just going to squeeze it all out. And I'm going to saute everything together.
Okay.
At this point, we have to break up our sausage now. And we want it all like a homogeneous texture, you know?
Yeah.
I want everything all mixed in together. And I have my temperature fairly high, which is good. Because I want some of the liquid to evaporate out. Sometimes in the South, when people make dressing, they'll take the old chicken gizzards and the necks and in the broth, and they'll peel the meat off and put it into this mixture also, which gives it another flavor, added flavor.
I wouldn't know if I want chicken gizzards, but
this smells safer.
Yeah.
Sausage is safer.
I like it.
We're just going to let all of this cook together, and then I'll show you the next steps.
Okay.
So now that our sausage is cooked, at this point, I'm gonna add a little bit of fresh marjoram, a little bit of freshly ground sage, a little bit of fresh thyme, a lot of fresh parsley, and I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of Keith's poultry seasoning.
That one's so good.
feels so good. You lying here next to me.
I know. That's about to take us.
You can sprinkle it on people and make them fall in love with you.
I know it.
I'm already in love. You don't have to say
it. Yeah. I'm in love with you too. Aww. All right, so here we go. This is ready. Now I'm going to take it, and we're going to take it over to the other side.
Okay.
You know, it really smells like my grandma's kitchen up in here. It
smells amazing.
I miss her so much. But through her legacy, I can show you how to make all of these wonderful meals. And I'm so thankful for that.
I'm thankful for you having me over. You're teasing me with all this great smelling food.
Well, I know you're going to love it.
I am.
So I'm going to take this homemade cornbread. This is about 6 cups of cornbread. All
right.
About 3 cups of white bread crumbs. Not white bread, but whole wheat bread crumbs.
Okay.
And I'm going to take all of this lovely sausage and peppers and onions and scallions. Oh, that smells so amazing. You know, I don't even wear cologne when I go out anymore. I just wear the scent of my cooking.
Ah, that's how you pull in all the ladies.
That's right. But this is really nostalgic for me, smelling all of these herbs and spices in this food. It's really incredible. At this point, I'm going to take my spoon and I'm just going to crush everything together.
Okay.
I want everything very nice and crushed.
How did you get started in cooking?
Well, my grandmother June started me when I was like 4 years old. And she would always bring me in the kitchen with her, making these types of meals. And I just loved it. It was so fun for me. I was so energized by the smell of the food. And once I got of age, I decided that this was going to be my career.
Wow. She was a smart lady because she helped a great cook come along.
Thank you so much. So at this point, we can see that the cornbread is broken up nicely, and so is those whole wheat bread crumbs, and it just smells absolutely amazing. You can see the peppers in here, you can see the parsley, you can see all of those herbs. So at this point, I'm gonna add a little bit more fresh green scallions.
Okay.
I'm gonna add a little bit more fresh parsley. You gotta have it fresh. I'm gonna crack 2 eggs. And now I'm gonna take some of that lovely gravy that we made earlier. Look how flavorful this looks. You can see the stewed turkey wings in here from earlier. You can see the carrots, you can see the parsley, and all of it contributes to the most perfect broth. So I'm gonna take a few cups of that, and I'm gonna pour it all on the top of here. And what we want to achieve is a nice moist texture. I'm going to mix everything together. Oh, that smells so good.
Mm-hmm.
And when you see it start to come together, then you know that you have enough liquid in there. Maria, could you please butter this pan for me?
Yeah!
Thank you.
No problem.
So while she's buttering that, I'm just going to take a little bit of black pepper. And I'm going to sprinkle some black pepper in there, because we all love black pepper. A little taste to make sure that everything is balanced. Oh my god, this is so good. Mmm! It doesn't need anything else.
I'm sure it does.
Mmm, taste this.
That is delicious.
Isn't it? I can't wait to eat it.
Me too.
And I can't wait to pour my turkey gravy over the top of it and just go to town on it.
Is this good?
A little bit more. We like our butter.
Okay.
Especially for dressing.
I'm not shy.
And get the sides too.
Alright.
There we go. And that, my dear, right here.
It's on there. Okay. It's just not shy.
And that, my dear, is perfect.
Okay.
So now I'm going to take some of this heavenly dressing and I'm just going to pour it all in our baking tray here. And now I'm just going to smooth it all out. Put a little bit more broth so it can be nice and moist. Spread everything out so it's like an even layer, so that when we slice it, we can have it and serve it in slices.
You can serve it to me any way you want.
That is good. Well, you're gonna love it, I know it. But But don't be giving out my recipe now. So after I spoon this out, it tastes so incredible. There's two more things that we have to add to this to make it the world's best dressing.
Okay.
And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take, here we go, put a little bit of honey, because this gives it an extra soul taste. There we go. So now I'm gonna take some paprika, and I wanna put paprika over the top color. Does that
so
look nice?
Pretty.
And after I put the paprika, I'm gonna take one of my other favorite ingredients in the world, truffle oil. Have a whiff of that.
It smells delicious.
If you've never tasted truffle oil before, you have to go out and get it. It gives it such a wonderful aroma of truffle mushrooms, and it just exemplifies the flavors of the dressing. It's absolutely amazing. So I'm gonna take this truffle oil and I'm gonna drizzle it generously over the top of my dressing. It's gonna give it such an incredible taste. And there we have it. Now all I have to do is pop this in the oven at 375 degrees and let it bake for about 35 minutes, just so that it can set and get golden brown on the top.
Perfect.
Well, folks, here you have it. Keith Lorren's homemade turkey wings and dressing. All made with love. You know, Maria, I can't wait to just sit down and feast myself on this decadent meal. To finish off the turkey, I have a little bit of freshly minced green scallions that I'm gonna drizzle all over the top like that. And then I'm gonna finish it finally with adding a little bit of some freshly chopped red Roma tomatoes. And this is just gonna give it that balance that only Keith Lorren can do. Folks, there you have it. Look at this feast I have laid out for you this evening. Turkey wings cooked with love and all of Keith Lorren's poultry sparks. We have macaroni and cheese, Keith Lorren's twice baked coconut yams, and finally, Grandma June's famous cornbread dressing. Folks, it just doesn't get any better than this. My name is Keith Lorren, and I invented cooking. And I'll see you next week.
So tender, it falls right off the bone.
That's how it's supposed
so
to be. This is real cooking. I'm glad you like it.
And it's all gone. But for now, I'm a celebrity. But now I'm a celebrity, 'cause I'm in love with the lights.